This is a question from a midterm exam of summer 2017. We have a capacitor. You are given a capacitor. It is charged to 100 volts. It's a parallel plate capacitor. The plates, the surface area of one of the plates is given in the problem as 2 meters square. And the distance between the plates is given as 1 millimeter. Okay. The surface area is 2 meters square and the distance between is just 1 millimeter. So the first question is, since the capacitor is charged, of course, there is, let's make the upper plate as plus charges and lower plate as minus charges. So obviously there is going to be electric field, right? Electric field will be created between the plates because you charge to 100 volts. And the question is, what is the strength of the electric field between the plates? This is the question. Okay. Any idea how we express the electric field between these plates if you know the potential difference between the plates is 100 volts and if you know the distance between the plates is 1 millimeter? Remember, we had this potential difference V2 minus V1 minus V2, etc., the integral. Minus integral from point 2 to 1, the electric field multiplied by dx. So if the electric field is just uniform, this integral is going to be electric field multiplied by some distance, all right? Remember this. So for a parallel plate capacitor, there is always this triple relation between electric field, the voltage, and the distance between the plates. And the voltage is always E times D. Okay, so keep this in mind. For a parallel plate capacitor, you have these triples, the electric field strength, the voltage between the plates, and the distance between the plates is always related to each other by this equation. Okay, keep this in mind. So that means E is just V divided by D. V is 100 volts and D is 1 millimeter or 10 to minus 3 meters, making the electric field strength as 100 kilovolt per meter, okay? Or kilonewton per coulomb. Remember, for electric field, the unit for the electric is you can either use volt per meter or newton per coulomb. Both is okay. So, but for the time being, for this context, we use volt per meter as the unit for the electric. Any questions for this? Kayıt oluyor. Ben kayıt ediyorum. Okay. So, what is next? B. This was the A part, and this was the midterm question, you know, it's that simple. B part is, what is the energy stored in this capacitor? What is the electrostatic energy stored in this capacitor? Okay. Sorry. This is not the capital U, it is small u. What is the energy density? Let me write this. Energy density, electrostatic energy density for this capacitor. Capital U is the total electrostatic energy stored in the capacitor. Small u is the energy density. The small u, if remember, I had formulated this in our lectures before we break up the school. And if you just check the notes, the electrostatic energy density between the plates of a capacitor is given by this equation. 1 over 2 epsilon 0 E electric field square. Okay, just use this equation. And since we already have found what E is, and epsilon 0 is just our physical constant, which is 8. What was it? Let me check. It is 8.85 times 10 to minus 12. And E is just 10 to 5 volt per meter. 100 kilovolt per meter is just 10 to 5 volt per meter. And you put over here, you get, I'm just writing the net result, 44.3 millijoules per meter cube. By what we mean energy density is the energy density per volume. Okay, so energy is joules and the volume is just a meter. So this was part B, part C. What is the total electrostatic energy stored in this capacitor? Okay.
So 88.6 değil mi hocam?
Evet. Sen bu örneği gördün galiba.
Yok, enerjinin korunumundan direkt 2 çarpı 1 çarpı 44.3 yapmayacağız mı?
So, if this result is just energy per volume, to find the total energy, you just multiply this energy per volume by the volume of the capacitor, right? So U is just the volume multiplied by the small u. So the volume is just this surface area multiplied by D, right? Volume of a box, the distance between the top plate and the bottom plate, and one of the plates area is given, so that's easy. 2 meters square multiplied by, you have to convert this to, you know, meter, 10 to power minus 3, multiplied by this 44.3. So you get the 88.6 microjoule. This is the total electrostatic energy stored. You can check for the energy stored in a capacitor. You can use, you know, other formulas. You can check the lecture notes. U can be expressed as 1 over 2 multiplied by C times V square. Okay, just to verify this result is correct. 1 over 2 C is, what is C? How do you find the C? C is just epsilon 0 surface area divided by D, right? These are all given. And epsilon 0 is a physical constant. And V is 100 volts, so you take 100 squared. You get the same result. If you check this, you will get the same result. And, or, you know, we have other forms. Instead of CV, you can use 1 over 2 Q square over C. This is another expression. Or, you know, 1 over Q times V. Both three equations you can use to find U. Okay. So, and this was all, but we have 10 minutes time to conclude this. And let me add one more question to this. Let me erase this part. I will use this as space. So you have your capacitor. D is at 1 millimeter. It is charged to 100 volts. What happens to the energy stored? What happens to the energy stored, total energy, if you just increase the distance between the plates to the new D is just to 2D, which is 2 millimeter. So you had these charges initially because it's charged to 100 volts. Now, in a way, you just increase the distance between the plates to twice of its original value, then new, what is going to be your new total electrostatic energy? That is the question. Is it going to change? If it changes, is it going to get larger or smaller?
4 katına çıkacak gibi duruyor hocam.
4 katına çıkacak. Evet. How?
Potansiyeli 2 katına çıktığı için hocam. Onun da karesini alırsak.
Hı hı.
Yani o şekilde 4 oluyor.
Potansiyel V prime is going to be 2V, you see. That means 200 volts. Right? How do you justify this? 200'e çıktığını nereden biliyorsun?
Yani yukarıda yazdığınız V eşittir ED formülü yazıyor ya hocam.
Evet. D'yi 2 katına çıkartıyoruz. Peki E'nin değişmediğini nereden biliyorsun? Bunu 2 katına
çıkartıyoruz. Yük miktarı değişmiyor hocam.
He?
Yük miktarı aynıysa delik falan değişir mi?
Değişir mi? E'yi şöyle ifade ettik ama E aslında yük cinsinden ya da yük yoğunluğu cinsinden neydi iki plate arasında? Sigma bölü epsilon sıfırdı değil mi? Sigma yük bölü surface area. The charge divided by surface area. If you change the distance, nothing happens to the charge. Charge will stay there. Charge doesn't change. If the charge doesn't change, sigma doesn't change. If sigma doesn't change, E doesn't change. E stays the same. If E stays the same, you increase D, you increase V. You increase V twice, it is going to be 200 volts. Okay. C is going to be same or not? So, okay. V prime is 200 volts. What next? Which formula are you going to use to find U? Let's use this formula. This formula has V, okay, we know, so let me write V prime, so U prime as 1/2 C prime multiplied by V prime square. So we know V prime is going to 200 volts. Do we know C prime? Does C changes when you increase D? Evet.
Evet değişecek hocam, o da yarıya düşecek. So, o zaman
in terms of old values. Let me write, by the way, let me write old values U0, 1/C0 and V0 square. And U prime as 1/C prime V prime square. C prime ne olacak? In terms of C0.
Yarıya düşecek.
The C prime will decrease, right? It's going to be C0 divided by 2. Because we know that C is epsilon 0 A divided by D. A is doesn't change. D gets twice. Then C prime is going to be half of the original value. So we know what the V prime. Let's put all these. 1/2 C, instead of C prime, I put C0 divided by 2. But V prime is going to be 2 V0. This is going to be 2 times V0 squared. So what is this? This is 4, this is 2. We will get the 2 times 1/2 C0 V0 squared, right? We have a factor of 2 over here. So what is this? This is the original energy. So we have factor of 2 over here. U prime is going to be twice the original energy. So when you increase the distance twice, you increase the energy stored to twice. by 2, by a factor of 2. Mesafeyi hiçbir şey değiştirmeden sadece mesafeyi artırdığınızda enerji iki katına çıkacak. Neden peki enerji bu iki katına çıkıyor? Nereden geliyor bu enerji peki?
Bizim yaptığımız işten geliyor hocam.
Evet. Biz bu plate'ler birbirini çekiyor mu? Çekiyor. Aslında bu arada artı var, burada eksi var. Ne yapıyoruz? O çekim gücüne karşı bir kuvvet uygulayıp daha, aralarını daha da açıyoruz. Yani aslında bir iş yapıyoruz. Bizim aslında bu yaptığımız iş ekstradan bir enerji olarak kapasitörü hanesine yazılır. Evet. Başka sorusu olan var mı arkadaşlar veya yorumu bu problemi?
Aslında hocam biz yaptığımız işi aldığımız mesafeyle çarpıyoruz ya. Aslında evet. Oradan bakarsak mesafe iki katına çıktığı için iş de iki katına çıkıyor aslında. Enerji de iki katına çıkıyor. Ama oradan da olabilir mi?
Şimdi ilk başta o zaman şöyle aralarındaki mesafenin sıfır olduğunu düşünüp ilk önce D'ye getirinceye kadar yaptığın iş. Onu hesaplaman lazım. Sonra 2D'ye çıkardığında o mantıkla dediğin doğru olur. Ama dediğin güzel bir şey. Şimdi iki tane plate var. Biri artı yüklü, biri eksi yüklü. Birbirlerine dokunmayacak şekilde üst üste geldiğini düşün veya aralarına çok ince bir kağıt koydun. Yalıtkan. Ve başladın çekmeye. Bu çekme hangi kuvvete karşı yapılacak? Eğer o kuvveti biliyorsan ilk baştaki U sıfırı da, yani ilk baştaki U'yu da, şu değeri de o kuvvet çarpı D ile bulabilirsin. Ama o mesele o kuvveti bulmak. İsterseniz onun hakkında biraz düşünün. Eğer bulamazsanız o kuvveti şey yapabiliriz. Yani ben size yardım edebilirim. Ama hemen şey yapmak istemiyorum. Biraz düşünün siz. Evet. O zaman bir 10 dakika ara vereceğim arkadaşlar. 10 dakika sonra yani saat 4'te yeni konuyla devam ederiz. 10 dakika sonra görüşmek üzere.